أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا ريسبكت برادرز، مي الله سبحانه وتعالى اكسبت اور صلاه. اللهم امين يا رب العالمين. اسال الله عز وجل ان يتقبل منا واياكم صالح الاعمال. اللهم امين. حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم narrated by الامام مسلم رحمه الله، he said صلى الله عليه وسلم اهل الجنه ثلاثه، the dwellers or the people of jannah they are three types of people or categories. Only these three categories or types of people? No. الغالبية, the majority of the people of Jannah gonna be from these three types. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم, number one, ذو سلطان مقسط متصدق موفق. A just ruler, somebody has authority, and his just man or just lady. People, they have a lot of authorities nowadays. مقسط يعني just, and also متصدق, he's giving sadaqah, and موفق. Now we have three characteristics, good characteristics for this man. He's just ruler, number one. This is his relationship with people. طيب, number two, متصدق. His relationship with Allah, he used to give sadaqah, عبادات. He worship Allah سبحانه وتعالى. His job did not occupy him, or he did not neglect his عبادة to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, because he is a president or a leader of a family, or somebody president and boss and job, certain job or something. You know, he used to worship Allah سبحانه وتعالى giving صدقة, and موفق, Allah guided him. That person, he will go to Jannah. Maybe somebody gonna tell me, Sheikh, I am not a ruler. You are a ruler. You are in your house, your family, right? You are the lord of the family, صح? You are the man. Do you have any doubt about that? Or الحكومة? Huh? رب الأسرة, yes. ما هو فيه رب الأسرة برضه. It depends. أيوة. فالمهم, the point here is, somehow you have certain authority. You are a ruler somehow. You have children, you are the ruler for them. You have a wife, you are the ruler for them. For somehow, somebody gonna tell me, I'm not one of them. No, you are. You have authority in your house. You are a just ruler between your kids, your family, whatever. For this man, he has too many good characteristics. He's just, his relationship with people, and also he is متصدق, relationship with Allah, he used to give sadaqah, and he is muwaffaq, he been guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These types of people will go to Jannah. Number two, وَرَجُلٌ رَحِيمٌ, a man, his heart is tender, rahim, soft, kind, gentle, nice, full of mercy, rahma to others. رَحِيمٌ رَقِيقَ الْقَلْبِ, soft, his heart is very soft. And when your heart is very soft, this is also a sign of iman. Those who are tough and harsh and hardened heart, these people, the hadith said, عُتُلٍ جَوَاظٍ مُتَكَبِّرٍ. These are the people of hellfire. عُتُل, stupid. جَوَاظ, harsh. متكبر, arrogant. These are people of hell. The opposite of this hadith, if your heart is soft, you're gentle, you're nice, you're dealing with people with akhlaq, manners, not Abu Jahl or Abu Lahab. سبحان الله. Yeah. سبحان الله. ورجل رحيم, a man, his heart has full of mercy. رقيق القلب, soft heart. لكل ذي قربة, and he's taking care of his kinship. He's very soft and nice with his kinship. And for every Muslim too. ولكل مسلم. I think there are too many of us, inshallah, of these people too. Number three, وعفيف متعفف ذو عيال. عفيف, is عفيف already. متعفف, he's trying to be عفيف. متعفف, it's difficult, but he's struggling to be عفيف. عفيف means what? Somebody has عز, عفة. Has too many meanings. عفة from doing haram. He never make anything haram. When he sees haram, he stopped. Yeah. عفيف. That hadith narrated by Imam Muslim is telling us too many messages here. He said, Rasulullah, the dwellers of Jannah, they are three. does not mean the dwellers of Jannah just these people. No, the majority of the people gonna be from them. When we explain here, أغلب أهل الجنة, we explain the meaning, and the second type of man, that man which is, he has mercy on his heart to all Muslims. That's why Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, المسلم أخو المسلم. Huh? لا يظلمه ولا يسلمه ويحبه. The Muslim is the brother of a Muslim. He's not oppressing him. He must be just with him. ولا يسلمه. Do not give your brother to his enemy. يسلمه يعني to give him to his enemy. You have to protect your brother. You see, some people, they are spying. Some people, they are doing a lot of things against Muslims. And this is against Islam, because this Muslim, he has rights upon you. You have to protect him. Even Rasulullah said that, أنصر أخاك ظالما أو مظلوما. قالوا يا رسول الله كيف ننصره وهو ظالم؟ قال برده عن ظلمه. He said, you have to support and help your brother, either if he's ظالم, oppressor, or he been oppressed from somebody. They said, يا رسول الله, if he will be oppressed from somebody, we're gonna stand with him. But how can we help him if he's oppressor himself? He said, to stop him from his oppression. Don't let him oppress somebody. You have to love your brothers. And you have to wish for your brother whatever you wish for yourself. This is rahmah, yes. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, beautiful hadith. I love this hadith so much. This hadith narrated by Imam Muslim also. لا تدخلوا الجنة حتى تؤمن. You will not enter Jannah until you believe. ولن تؤمنوا حتى تحابوا. Your iman will never be perfect iman, faith, until you love each other. I have a prescription from you. Who? Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, أولا أدلكم على شيء إذا فعلتموه تحببتم. Would I tell you, or should I tell you about something? If you'll do it, you're gonna love each other. Say, Ya Rasulullah, what's your prescription? He said, أفشي السلام بينكم. Say salam to everybody. Say salam to one you know, and to the one you don't know also. Say salam to everybody. And that sister, she became Muslim yesterday, or the day before yesterday, she was asking me, Assalamu alaikum. She's trying to learn Arabic, mashallah. 2 days in Islam, and she knows the tahiyyat now, and she knows a lot of things. Allahi. And she told me, Assalamu alaikum. What is the meaning of Assalamu alaikum? I said, in Islam, when you say salam to somebody, Assalamu alaikum means there is no harm from me to you. This is the meaning of salam. To many Muslims, they don't know even its meaning. Even they did not say Assalamu alaikum, they say Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum. Like that. Assalam means death. Assalam means peace. Assalamu alaikum. They say Assalamu alaikum. فرشاوي طيب الله يرحم العباد فالسلام السلام not السام السام means death when a Jewish guy came to رسول الله and he said السلام عليك and رسول الله السلام said upon you too وعليك yeah عائشة start cussing she said عائشة didn't you know what I answer he said السلام عليك death upon you I said upon you too that's it yeah وعليك see فالسلام also when you say سلام don't say سلام على من اتبع الهدى You're not Musa, I'm not Fir'aun. One brother, he was memorizing Quran for 7 years. I was sitting here with some brothers. He said, As-salamu ala man ittaba' al-huda. I told him, انت بتشتغل ايه? Musa, انت واحنا فرعنا? Excuse me, I was bad to him during that day. يعني انت حافظ قرآن, المفروض you have to understand. He said, As-salamu ala man ittaba' al-huda. Most of the brothers were mashayikh, all of us. He said, As-salamu ala man ittaba' al-huda. Salam to those who are following guidance. This is Musa said it to Fir'aun. I'm not Fir'aun. We have the salutation, the greeting of Islam. اسمها السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Or السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. Or the minimum السلام عليكم. Huh? That is the minimum. Don't tell me السلام على متابع الهدى. عيب. عيب. ف رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said you have to spread this word. Peace. السلام عليكم. السلام عليكم. This is peace. Also you have to know its meaning too. When I say السلام عليك means no harm from my tongue or my hand to you. I will never gonna harm you because I already gave you salam. Yes, peace be upon you. Yeah. And in general, brothers and sisters, الرحمون يرحمهم الرحمن. Those who have mercy to others, Allah will have mercy on them. When somebody sees somebody poor, you give him some food or some money or whatever. When you see somebody orphaned and you give him hug and you... Wallahi, subhanAllah. More you have mercy to someone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gonna look at you. Because Mercy is very important. But start with your family first, your wife and your kids. فاقد الشيء اللي يعطيه. How can I give something while I don't have it? See? Very important. Start with your family. ابدأ بمن تعول. الأقربون أولى بالمعروف. Too many things. Start with the family, with those who are near to you. And they said, ورجل عفيف متعفف ذو عيال. That man, he is poor. He has kids. Means he's suffering to get food for them. And he's عفيف. عفيف also has different meaning. He's not begging people for help. While he need. He is in need because he has children. ذو عيال. عيال means a lot of children. But he wanted to tell you, help me. But he said, I have عفة. عفة means I cannot ask you. I have dignity. And عفيف also means he's not doing haram. يعف نفسه عن الحرام. He has power. That power is carrying him away from الحرام. Doing haram or anything bad. This is the meaning of عفيف. سبحان الله. And also, العفيف صاحب القوة المناعة عن الفواحش. The قوة الإيمان. He has strong إيمان. Like سيدنا يوسف. When the زليخة, she seduced him. What did he say? Young, strong. Allah give him half of the beauty. She's a very beautiful lady. She's the lady of the palace. He's a slave. And he was a stranger. He's from Palestine. يعني nobody knows him in Egypt. He can do haram. يعني imagine somebody's coming from different country. He come to America. Nobody knows me. He can do whatever I want. يلا خلاص. Haram is easy. سيدنا يوسف, he said no. قال معاذ الله. Allah forbid. It's not me. إنه ربي أحسن مثواي. See, this is, he has power of iman. That power stopped him from doing الفحشة. Yeah, سبحان الله. فالحديث again, غالب أهل الجنة, the majority of the people of Jannah, they gonna be one of these or these three types of Muslims: the Sultan, the just ruler, and second person, the one who has mercy and rahmah; the third, the one who has power to stop him from doing any kind of unlawful or haram or stuff like that. And the Shurah al-Hadith, they explain this. They said, for example, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الخمر من هاتين الشجرتين العنب والنخلة. The خمر from these two trees, the grapes and the palm trees. Only الخمر from them, the majority of الخمر from them. But الخمر you can make it from day, from rice, from anything, zabib, from anything else, right? For the majority of people, they make الخمر from grapes and from dates. But other thing they can say. فهذا التقسيم لا يفيد الحصر ولكن الغالب. الحصر means just only these three that are going to go to Jannah? No. But the majority of the people of Jannah are going to be out of one of these three, all of these three, all of them. فتry to be one of them, inshallah, رب العالمين. Try to have mercy. Yes, to somebody. Try to have عفة, power of iman to stop you from doing haram. Or be just when you deal with anybody, especially with Muslims and your family and your kids and all of that. And this, if we talk in details about this hadith, we can talk a lot. We'll give you example of Sayyidina Yaqub and how somehow what happened to Sayyidina Yusuf and how his brothers, they felt he used to love Yusuf more than they see. And in your house, you have to be just. Even when you kiss one of the children, you have to kiss another one. You give to one of your children something, give to all the same. Because maybe they can hate one of them, like Sayyidina Yusuf and his brothers. See, there are too many details you can talk about, inshallah. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يا رب العالمين أن يغفر لي ولكم وأن يسترنا ويجبرنا ويرحمنا ويتقبل منا يا رب العالمين. نسألك يا ربنا الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى يا أرحم الراحمين. نسألك تيسير الأمور يا رب العالمين. اللهم عافنا واسترنا واجبرنا ويسر أمورنا وتقبل منا واغفر لنا. نسألك يا رب الرشد والهداية والتوفيق يا أرحم الراحمين. واغفر لنا يا ربنا ولوالدين ولمن كان له حق علينا. وانظر إلينا يا ربنا نظرة رضا تحرم بها أجسادنا ووجوهنا ودماءنا عن النار. اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما. ولا تجعل فينا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما يا رب العالمين. واشف من كان منا مريضا يا أرحم الراحمين. وفقنا لما تحب وترضاه يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نستودعك ديننا وخواتم أعمالنا يا أرحم الراحمين. صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.